adobe, ochre in Taos, New Mexico. Red mud brick in Morocco's Atlas Mountains. Toulouse, the pink city. Malta, honey-coloured limestone. Neuchâtel and its Yellowstone. The town has quite a picturesque appearance thanks to its old castle, wrote Alexandre Dumas in Switzerland, the account of a visit he made in 1832. And he added, there's just one thing that spoils it, and that's the yellowish colour of the stones used for the walls, which make the town look like a huge toy carved out of butter. Luckily for Neuchâtel, another great French author was more enthusiastic. Honoré de Balzac, who in 1833 stayed at the Hôtel du Faucon, a building whose function has changed a little since then. Balzac was in Neuchâtel for his first meeting with his mysterious Polish admirer, Countess Ewelina Hanska, who was to be his mistress and eventually his wife. In a letter he sent her on October 21st, he wrote, Neuchâtel is like a white lily, pure, full of strong scents. However that may be, the dominant colour in Neuchâtel is undeniably yellow. What gives the city and its region its colour is so-called Hauterive stone. Hauterive, to the east of Neuchâtel, was where the strata of yellow stone were of high enough quality to make them suitable for excavation. The stone has left its mark on the old village of Hauterive and on its newer parts. The yellow stone is a type of limestone. It was formed by sediments laid down 130 million years ago when the region lay beneath the sea. The Yellowstone was being excavated as long ago as Roman times. On the other side of the lake, the town of Aventicum, Avenches, and its surrounding wall were built mainly with Hauterive stone. The blocks were transported by ship to the construction sites. It was the beginning of a long history. Medieval architects made plenty of use of Yellowstone. As the castle of Neuchâtel shows, and the cathedral, where the play of light from the stained glass windows transforms the colour of the stone. The yellow stone is to be found again in the Abbey Church in Payerne in nearby Canton Vaud. Indeed, use of the yellow stone spread through the region of the Three Lakes, wherever places could be reached by water transport. In Neuchâtel, the yellow stone was used in the construction of numerous buildings, both public and private, from the Middle Ages to the end of the 19th century. And for decoration too. At the beginning of the 20th century, the best strata were becoming exhausted, and the cost of excavating the yellow stone rose. The last quarries in the Hauterive area closed in the 60s and 70s. But that didn't mean the people of Neuchâtel were going to give up the colour that gave their city its identity. They started using substitutes, stone from elsewhere, cladding, imitation, mortar with crushed yellow stone, paint, etc. One exception to this cultural colouring, the Church of Our Lady, built at the turn of the 19th and 20th centuries. Indeed, Yellowstone has had to get used to cohabiting with other colours in a number of different styles. Even so, the yellow is still there, time-worn, under renovation, renovated, in all its diversity. Today, Yellowstone is no longer excavated to any large extent, but the Cernier quarry still exists in the heights above Neuchâtel. And in Haute-Rive, the quarries are recalled not only in the name of a lane, but also in a black and white memento of the workers who gave a whole region its colour.